The Dwight D. Eisenhower Executive Office Building, the EEOB, has occupied a prominent place next to the White House for almost 150 years. The Illustrated History, Palace of State, edited by Thomas Lubka and published by the Commission of Fine Arts, details the building's rich architectural and historical legacy and documents how the building has evolved. Built to house three of the oldest and most important executive departments of the United States government, State, War, and Navy, the colossal granite building holds almost 2 miles of corridors and 553 rooms. Designed in the Second Empire style, it is strikingly different from the predominantly neoclassical government buildings in Washington, D.C. Construction of the landmark building began on June 21, 1871, with the demolition of the former White House stables. When it was completed on January 31, 1888, after 17 years of construction, it was the largest office building in the nation's capital and among the largest in the world. In 1887, an admirer of the building wrote to the Washington Post that the almost unanimous opinion now is that the State, War, and Navy Department building is the most beautifully proportioned public building in the world, and that utility has been by no means sacrificed to beauty. The uniform interior spaces were enlivened by leading American interior designers who deployed opulent finishes and furnishings in a wealth of rich colors, patterns, and textures. A major restoration of the interiors was undertaken a century later in the 1980s, and on May 7, 2002, President George W. Bush officially renamed the building the Dwight D. Eisenhower Office Building in honor of President Eisenhower, who, as a young Army officer, had worked in the State, War, and Navy building in several positions. Today, the building survives as one of the foremost examples of Second Empire design in the United States, and it now serves as the home of the Executive Office of the President.